We got a 3A title game on tap between Morton and North Lawndale. Let's take a look to see how North Lawndale got here. The 3A state championship in this one set to be underway in a minute. Let's take a quick look, though. The Lady Phoenix shooting it from the word go in the semifinals, doing so from long distance. They were holding on to a three-point lead in the final seconds of regulation when Highland's Reese Portell with a gut punch at the buzzer to tie it. The Lady Phoenix, not to be denied, though, took two overtimes, but they get the job done. And now in their first trip to the state tournament, looking for their first ever state title. I've got their head coach right now, Corey Morgan. Coach, 8 extra minutes yesterday in 2 overtimes. How'd the girls' legs feel today? How do they look today?
They look great. They look fresh. They look confident. We got a lot of rest last night. They hydrated their bodies. I think they're ready to go. They're just excited.
You have played Morton. You gave them one of their 3 losses this year. How does that change your ability to game plan coming into this one?
It doesn't change anything. We beat them in quadruple overtime. We know that Morton's a phenomenal team, defending state champs. So we just got to come out here and execute and play some defense today.
Do you feel like because of that you're playing with nothing to lose today? They're the defending state champ. Maybe they're the ones that are the favorites coming in, all the attention on them?
Absolutely. Number one team in the state, all the pressure on them. No one thought we would be here. We're not supposed to be here. We're just trying to have fun and represent our school and city.
4 overtimes the last time you saw them. How many will you play today if you need to?
Hopefully 9. Hopefully we can end it in regulation.
Corey Morgan, the head coach, good luck today. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All righty, guys. We've got a state championship coming up in a moment between Morton and North Lawndale. And when we get back, we will talk to Bob Becker, the head coach of the Morton Potters. We'll be back after this. Just moments away from a 3A state championship game between the defending state champs Morton and North Lawndale. This stage, nothing new for the Morton Potters. The defending state champions making their 4th trip to Redbird Arena in the last 10 years. That experience was on full display yesterday in the semifinal win over Morgan Park. Morton ranked 1 in the state, Morgan Park 2 coming into that contest. But the Potters controlled it from the tip. Jadison Warren, a 7-for-7 effort from the field in the first half. She had 15. Brandy Bisping had a game-high 21. Morton earned their chance to defend the crown with a dominant 15-point win. And I've got their head coach who they're chanting, Bobby B, behind us, Coach Bob Becker. The girls look comfortable on this stage yesterday. That's got to give you confidence going into today's championship game.
A little bit. I think that experience pays off. They've been there. They've done that. Now they just have to find a way to execute again. Yesterday, they executed wonderfully. I think they're ready to go today, too.
An epic 4 overtime game against this North Lawndale team. You guys have 3 losses on the season. They gave you 1 of them. Does that provide additional motivation heading into today, or do you need it?
Well, we shouldn't need it. I mean, you know, Coach Davis said if they need extra motivation, if we got a rah-rah for a chase championship, you know, they don't have a pulse or something wrong there. But our kids are ready. I think they'd like to avenge that loss, but it doesn't matter. We're excited to be here and take on whoever's in front of us.
You guys expected to be here. Is there some relief being here today, knowing that all those expectations that you're in this position right now?
Maybe so. I mean, it's a great accomplishment for our kids, but they're not done yet.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck today.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Bob Becker, the head coach of the Morton Potters. His defending champion Potters getting ready to take on North Lawndale in this 3A title game tips momentarily. They're trying to get him away from us and get him over to the coaches meeting, the captain's meeting. TV man, I tell you what. It's a 3A state championship game, and it's coming up in just moments here. You are looking at Redbird Arena on the campus of Illinois State University in Normal, and the road to Redbird ends today for the top 8 girls basketball teams between class 3A and 4A at the state tournament. Championship Saturday upon us. 2 more titles to be handed out today. We've got 1 of them ready to go in just moments between the defending 3A champs, the Morton Potters, and North Lawndale, the Phoenix. Welcome in, everyone. Zach Kirker at Doug Collins Court, where we've got that 3A title bout underway for you in just a moment. We'll get to that, but first let's take a look at what's happened so far and what else you can expect right here on CSN throughout the day. Highland beat Morgan Park 62-51 in that 3A consolation matchup. And then tonight when we come back, 6:30 tonight, Whitney Young and Trinity will play in the 4A consolation game. That game tips at 4:30. And then Friend and Bennett Academy, that is a rematch of last year's 4A championship game that Bennett Academy won, so we could have 2 back-to-backs before it's all said and done. Should be a great day of girls high school hoops. With the call of your 3A title game, we send it over to Lee Hall and Tara Wellman.
All right, Zach, thanks a bunch. It's number one Morton, the defending state champs, against unranked North Lawndale. And really, Tara, you wonder how either team got here. North Lawndale's unranked. And even though Morton's number one, they lost their best player, their top scorer earlier in the year. But here they are trying to defend their state title.
Of course, playing without Chandler Ryan. But both of these teams had a tough battle to get here, just to get to this point. Big stage for both of them, both looking to come away with a championship today.
Let's take a look at our key player. First for the Phoenix, Kia Brooks, coming off an outstanding semifinal against Highland.
She is dynamite on the floor. 21 points yesterday, 5 rebounds. She's scrappy, she's tough. She's gonna play defense. She's gonna be all over the floor.
For the Morton Lady Potters, Jadison Warham's always been a solid player, but maybe the best game of her career yesterday.
She was the spark plug that got that game started for the Potters yesterday. She had 15 points. She was 7-for-7 in the first half. It was like she couldn't miss, and that's what set the stage for that dominant Potters win yesterday.
It's a first trip ever for North Lawndale's girls. For the Morton Lady Potters, it's same old, same old. This is their third trip to state in the last 4 years. They've grown up with it. We'll see if that experience pays off for the defending state champs. 3A state championship action coming your way next on Comcast Sportsnet. It's number one and defending state champ Morton against unranked North Lawndale. Let's go to our longtime PA announcer, Jeff Fritzen.
We ask you to stand, and prior to our guest solo singing the national anthem, remember and honor the men and women of the United States Armed Forces serving throughout the world with this moment of silence. Thank you. And now we ask that you join our guest soloist, Amaya Crockrum, a junior at Chicago Whitney Young High School, in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land and of the free, and the
And now, here are your starting lineups for the Class 3A 2016 IHSA Girls State Basketball Championship. First, for the Morton Potters, number one, Tinley Dowell. For the Phoenix of North Lawndale College Prep, number one, Kia Brooks. From Morton, number three, Josie Becker. For North Lawndale, number three, Marquita Thorne. For Morton, number 13, Brandy Bisping. For North Lawndale, number five, Deshanae Bibby. For Morton, number 15, Kayla McCormick. For North Lawndale, number 11, Jada Thorpe. For Morton, number 30, Jadison Warham. And for North Lawndale, number 32, Kimaira McGee. Morton brings a 32-3 record into the championship game. The Potters are coached by Bob Becker.
All right, there you have our starting lineups. A road to the state finals, fourth for the Phoenix of North Lawndale. Not much trouble in the regionals. Look at that low scoring game in the sectional semis against Glenbard South, 31-22. A 3-point win over Marshall, which avenged an earlier loss to them from the regular season. They beat Johnsburg and then got by Highland in double overtime yesterday in the state semifinals. For the Morton Lady Potters, the defending state champs, they're just about 30 miles from Redbird Arena, but this is how they got here on the road to state, beating U High and Notre Dame out of Peoria. 46-29 win over Prairie Central in the sectional semis. Conference arch rival Washington, they beat them by 7. That was the third meeting between those teams this year. Low scoring affair against Burlington Central in the Super, and then a pretty good defensive effort yesterday against Morgan Park, winning 54-39. Bob Becker in his 17th year as head coach at Morton, 378 wins, 142 losses, fifth 30-win season in his run at Morton. This is the fourth trophy for the Potters since 07. They were fourth in 07 and 2013, state champions a year ago, trying to defend that here today. On the other side, Corey Morgan in his fourth year as head coach at North Lawndale, 77 and 44. He's won state titles as a grade school coach at the IHSA level, trying to do it here in the IHSA. This is a rematch of an earlier game, Tara, played in the State Farm Classic, a 4-overtime win for the Lady Phoenix. They hit 4 buzzer beaters in that one and knocked off Morton.
And when you think of a 4-overtime game, you probably don't think of a final score of 48-46, so a low-scoring affair there as well. But these two teams have played a lot since then.
North Lawndale in the zone. The Phoenix held the ball a lot in that game. We'll see how they play it here against the Potters.
As they did in the semifinal yesterday.
Here's Josie Becker, the coach's daughter. Now kicks to Kayla McCormick. Not a big score for the Potters. In fact, she missed all of her shots yesterday, but the senior hits her first shot today.
Took advantage of the open baseline there with a good look at the basket.
Jada Thorpe with it. Her dad is the boys coach. Lewis Thorpe had a nice chat with him before the game. She'll try the long three. That's Gabrielle Cooper range from our consolation game. Saved out of bounds, and it'll be Lady Phoenix ball. Check out the hustle. Kamaira McGee chasing it down. Another miss for the Lady Phoenix. Here come the Potters in transition. 32-3, a win in this championship game would tie last year's program record for wins in a season at 33. Randy Bisping nowhere to go. She's the leading scorer for the Potters. Here's Jadison Warham. She hit all 7 of her first half shots yesterday, misses her first attempt here. And now the Potters will reload. McCormick for 3. Rolled off the top of the backboard, and it'll go to North Lawndale. Thorpe almost has it taken away. Last touch by Morton. North Lawndale 23-11, unranked out of the public league. And they play the best teams in the state. They lost to Trinity, who we'll see here tonight in the 4A state semifinal, rather the third place game tonight. They lost to Proviso East. They lost to Whitney Young. They lost to Marshall. So they played the better big schools in the state.
this Morton team is pretty known this season for their defense. We talked about how they held the high-scoring Morgan Park team to under 40 points. That has been the story of their season. Not the highest scoring team themselves, but so stingy on defense, just very disciplined.
Well, we asked Bob Becker, the Morton head coach, yesterday after his team's defensive effort. They held Morgan Park to 2 third-quarter points. He said, points, where our team is happy to hang our hats on defense. We lost an All-Stater in Chandler Ryan, their top scorer, and they've kind of hung their hat on defense all season long, and it's gotten even better in the postseason. We can talk more about that in a bit. 3 minutes gone here in the state championship game, a 2-0 lead for Morton. Both teams kind of playing it close to the vest here in the early going. Josie Becker misses the three. She hit a three in the third quarter yesterday. McCormick takes it away. Good defender. Excellent soccer player.
Trying to work it inside, but credit to that Phoenix defense under the basket. Not a lot of room.
Kick out to Tinley Dowell, the freshman. Her 19th three of the season. Good start for the Potters. Kia Brooks can't get the layup to roll. The follow, Deshaunae Bibby. Kia Brooks, miss, and the foul on North Lawndale. It'll be Morton ball when we come back. Tinley Dowell, just a 5'9 freshman. She can flat out shoot it, though. She knocks down the three. The Potters out to an early 5-0 lead.
Hi, my name is DeAsa Almond from North Lawndale College Prep. If I won a lottery, I would spend it on my family. My favorite late night snack is some Rice Krispies or something. If I could have any three wishes, I would wish for three more wishes. My favorite childhood TV show is Dragon Tales. My favorite food is macaroni, because, like, the cheese in your mouth, delicious. The things I do for a pregame, I think about how I should play, and my uncle and stuff.
She's all about the macaroni and cheese, isn't she?
Can't go wrong with good mac and cheese.
Morton with the lead. They won 12 straight coming into the state championship game. Kaylee Jones, number 33, now into the ball game for Morton. The give to Dowell, in and out. Nice high-low look from Jadison Warren that time. Kia Brooks with that wrap on her wrist. She was icing it last night watching 4A action here at Redbird Arena. Almond misses the three.
Coach Morgan says that she's in range as soon as she crosses half court. Just a pure shooter.
5 minutes gone here in the opening quarter, only 5 points.
Not surprising based on what we've seen, especially from the Morton team.
Very disciplined Morton team under Bob Becker. Patient. Their leading scorer, Chandler Ryan, a season-ending ACL injury December 15th. Dowell looks to score inside. She's fouled. And it'll go against Kamira McGee.
We talked about how disciplined they are to work inside.
Kenley Dowell, just a 56% free thrower. She won the NBA National Dribble Dish and Swish Contest when she was 8 and 9 years old. I remember covering that story. She went to the NBA All-Star Games in Dallas and LA to win those competitions.
So she's familiar with repeating titles.
Wow, yes, indeed she is. Good catch there. 7-0 Morton. They held Morgan Park to 2 points in the third quarter. So far, they've held North Lawndale scoreless, although the Lady Phoenix have been kind of painfully patient here in the early going. Good look that time from Kia Brooks. Couldn't get it to roll in. This is something I was interested to see yesterday as Tenley Dow gets loose inside again and can't get the layup to go. Morgan Park allowed Morton to run offense a lot yesterday. Didn't really get up in the grill, didn't double team or pressure as much as I thought they might. And we're seeing a little bit of that here as Morton picks up the foul.
Well, this is, we keep using the word disciplined about this Morton team because they're very methodical about the way they go about setting up their offense, running their offensive sets. But you can disrupt that if you're aggressive enough defensively. We didn't see that from Morgan Park, with the exception of occasionally in that full court pressure. We're seeing a lot of the same so far from the Phoenix.
Jada Thorpe, not a very good shot selection that time as McCormick misses the three. Warham the rebound, and the Potters come out of there with it. Kaylee Jones picked it up after Warham initially had it.
Coach Becker said, especially without Chandler Ryan this year, this offense isn't real great at freelancing. They run their sets for a reason. So if North Lawndale can get them out of those sets, force them to maybe take a shot they're not comfortable with, it could get them out of this zone that they're in right now.
Kia Brooks takes it to the hole after she came up with the steal at the other end, and she draws the foul and will go to the line. Fouls on Dow. And Kia Brooks will go to the line, averaging 8.8 points a game, 5'9 junior. She had 21 in yesterday's semifinal win over Highland. That's the first point for North Lawndale. So they go over 7 minutes without scoring. Still haven't scored a field goal here in the opening quarter.
Brooks was 8 for 10 from the free throw line yesterday, but they're going to need more than free throws to get going here.
Becker tied up. Free throw line jumper won't go. Brooks on the glass again. She averages 6 boards a game. Now the takeaway by Tia Sherman. Cassidy Sherman, rather, just into the ball game. Bisping, haven't heard her name today. 15 seconds to go now, opening quarter. North Lawndale trying to get their first field goal of the game. Kia Brooks will have to beat the buzzer to get it done. And a travel on Allman.
There's such a loud student section at the end of the floor that North Lawndale is shooting at right now.
Last second attempt.
Sure.
For Bisping is no good. Sorry about that.
I'm not sure they can hear themselves right now, which isn't helping their case.
A 7-run inning for the Potters. It's 7-1 after one. Fire fans, it's finally time. The 2016 MLS season is here. Get your favorite Chicago soccer team as they kick off their season with their home opener against the New York City FC. Coverage starts tomorrow, 12:30, right here on Comcast Sportsnet. The Lady Phoenix without a field goal in the opening quarter, and we talked about that Morton defense and how it's picked up here in the postseason. Before yesterday's semifinal, they were allowing just 30 points a game in the first 5 games of March Madness. And they allowed 39 yesterday. Six of those came very late. Nine of those actually came very late.
Coach Becker said ahead of the game, if we can hold Morgan Park to 30, I'd say that'd be a pretty solid victory. They almost did it.
Brandi Bisping brings it up. She stepped out of bounds with the pressure from the Phoenix, and it'll be North Lawndale ball. Brandi Bisping, 14 and a half points a game. Her sister, Brooke, is an assistant coach and played for Morton when they made it to state. Her brother, Brett, plays for Siena. Was a conference. There's a good look at Brooke Bisping. Played her college ball at Bradley University just down the road.
It's a little bit of basketball in the family.
A lot.
She probably gets more coaching than she knows what to do with.
And the turnover on the Lady Phoenix. Bisping's live on kind of a rural road just outside of town, and they have a barn. It's got a basketball hoop in it. Spent a lot of time out there.
She had an interesting game yesterday. 21 points in that game, 19 of which came on free throws.
It was a strategy that worked well against Morgan Park. They owned the lane. They wouldn't let Morgan Park in the lane defensively, and they attacked offensively, just as she does here. Right on cue, Brandi Bisping to the hoop, the bucket and one, and she's headed back to that free throw line where she made a lot of hay yesterday.
Great move, very aggressive. Saw her chance and took advantage. Fist pump after the fact, too.
Brandi had 21 in yesterday's win over Morgan Park. Very likely going to be a Division I volleyball player. Although she's going to have to turn down some basketball offers, I think, before it's all said and done. 10-1, the Morton lead. Still no field goals for the Lady Phoenix. And a tie-up on the rebound. And that'll go to Morton. Bisping with the hustle there. Corey Morgan wondering what he's got to do to get his team to get a bucket.
Well, that was a better look than they've had a number of times down the floor. The Morton defense came out a little bit, looked like to maybe put a little bit of pressure on, and she almost got around it for a good shot. Just can't get it to fall.
Morton beats the full court pressure. And Josie Becker bounces it over the backboard. She did not play last year as a freshman. Torn ACL, she's still wearing that brace. Her dad, the coach, Bob, put her out in the semifinals just to get her on the floor. She just, I remember standing there listening to her, just stand on the bench, just stand in front of the bench. And that's what she did, but she's been a force for this team to get them back to state without their leading scorer, Chandler Ryan, who's over there on the bench helping coach.
Dealing with the same injury.
Well, she actually went to Josie and asked her a lot of advice. She's out of the brace now, but recovering. She's going to play college ball at Florida Gulf Coast, I should say. Bisping to miss, Warren the rebound. Dowell takes it to the hoop, off the window and good for the freshman. Tenley Dowell with 7 points. It's a 12-1 Morton lead. Tough shot and finish. And going to the line for the three-point play will be Jada Thorpe, the freshman. Freshman scores at the other end. Freshman scores at the opposite end, Jada Thorpe. Strong move.
A couple of talented freshmen. They may see each other again at this level.
First field goal of the game for North Lawndale comes at the 5:48 mark in the second quarter. Honorable mention All-Stater, 77% at the line. Three-point play.
Here comes the pressure again.
Becker beats it. Warren almost walked. Can't finish, and the rebound dragged down there. Kamira McGee, very strong on the boards. Kia Brooks takes it all the way. That's the one thing Morgan Park really wasn't able to do against this Morton team yesterday, at least not with a lot of regularity. It's a 6-point game now.
North Lawndale was content to be pretty patient early on, but they have really picked it up, put the pressure on defensively.
Good defense there by Bisping to knock away a sure layup attempt. Becker gives to Dowell. She has it blocked out of bounds. Kinley Dowell, not bashful as a freshman. Boy, she will take that ball to the hole strong. Has it knocked away there. Morton out to a 12-6 lead. A lot of defense, a lot of movement here in the early going. Back at Redbird Arena, Lee Hall, Tara Wellman, Zach Kirker with you. Morton a 12-6 lead. North Lawndale showing a little life in the second quarter after falling behind 12-1. This team was 6-7 before the State Farm Classic, which is played here in Bloomington Normal. So a real turning point in the season here, right in the 309, which is the area code for this area. State Farm Classic changed the whole tone of the season, according to Corey Morgan. Since then, they have wins against Whitney Young, Morgan Park, Marshall, Loyola. Well, those were the only losses, I should say. So they've really picked it up, and a turning point here at tournament time. You get a lot of team bonding in those situations and learn a lot about your team in a short amount of time.
He used the words locked in to describe how they beat Morton in that tournament game. Haven't quite gelled like that yet today, but having done it, they know they're capable.
Jadison Warham's sister, J.C. Warham, number 40 into the ball game. Now Dowell takes it to the hoop again, but the defense was there that time. Deshane Bibby. Here's Bisping, left alone, takes it to the hole, and she'll go to the line for her second three-point opportunity of this game.
She's feeling it early. Patient, waited, then made a strong move to the basket with the finish.
5'11 junior Brandi Bisping, 86% at the line this season, 19 of 21, as Tara mentioned yesterday in the semifinal win over Morgan Park. A rare miss there. Let's go to Zach Kirker.
Hey guys, I was in that last timeout with North Lawndale, and Corey Morgan was telling the girls, we have been here before. You guys were talking about that State Farm Classic. They trailed in the championship game to Rock Island 16-3 in that game, came back and won it 42-39. So in championship games, they have been down big deficits before and been able to come back and win them. That'll be important today.
Kamira McGee, a nice power move inside. Thanks, Zach. 6-foot junior. Using her body to post up and score. Back to a 6-point game. I feel like the tempo has picked up a little bit more in this game in the last few minutes.
It certainly has. Really on both ends of the floor, we talked about how North Lawndale needed to be aggressive defensively.
Becker knocks in the three.
It's hard to guard that.
Just like that, it's a 9-point Morton lead. And North Lawndale aggressive on offense at the other end.
You mentioned the strong move under the basket and then on the other end of the floor. Well, if you're going to be tough inside, we'll just go back outside.
44-3 of the season for Josie Becker. Jadison Warren checks in for Kayla McCormick. The turnover. Becker and Dowell running the floor. Now kicks it back out. Bisping three is good. 40th three of the year. Back-to-back threes for the Potters, and they lead by 12.
Bisping is in some kind of zone right now. And the Phoenix don't seem to have an answer yet. Coach Morgan wants to talk that one over.
Check out Brandi Bisping.
Good look on the pass by Dowell. Nice and easy.
Brandy's getting looks in basketball. We mentioned volleyball was her really her number one sport. Illinois State, Lafayette among those taking a look at her for basketball. We mentioned her bloodlines. They're in the sweatsuit giving fives is Chandler Ryan. She's been a big cheerleader and a big help for this team. She can't play, but it has not affected her. After the first couple of days, she got over it, and she has been a real boost for this team on the bench. In fact, in one of the first games when she was on the bench, she called timeout. One of the players got tied up, and she called timeout.
She's a natural.
Kia Brooks for three. Yeah, it's kind of funny to hear that story. Coach Becker said he looked at Bill Davis's assistant. They looked at each other like, who called timeout? And it was Chandler Ryan, a heady player, a heady assistant coach.
Maybe a little too, team.
Maybe a little too heady. I don't think she's called timeout since then.
Maybe not. She's helping in other ways. Tell you, Kia Brooks can help her team if she can get going.
De'Asa Allman with a nice little runner. Her first points of the afternoon. Couple of buckets in a row for the Lady Phoenix. They get within seven. Need a stop here. Final 2 minutes opening half, 3A state championship action. Jadison Warham, that's her shot. Made her first seven attempts, and now Kamira McGee slow to get up the floor, favoring her knee. Allman, the miss on the drive. And Brandi Bisping will slow it down a little bit. Both Warham sisters in there now, Jadison and JC. Now Tenley Dowell with it, the freshman. Now the tempo is kind of, the pace is kind of settled back into what we saw earlier in the game.
And this is Morton's game. This is where they want this pace to stay.
Back cut for Bisping. Follows. Another three-point attempt for the junior. She's got 10. She's hit a three-point shot. She had an old-fashioned three-point play to start the game. She had another shot at it, missed the free throw. This will be her third chance at the old-fashioned three-point play.
Brooks might have gotten a piece of that first attempt there by Bisping, but she was not going to be stopped.
Morton leading the second chance points 9-0.
And another free throw.
Bisping with 11. She averages 14.5 a game. North Lawndale can't keep pace offensively, and they turn it over here.
Good help defense there, creating a mistake.
Becker avoids the double team, brings it across, and she's fouled. De'Asa Allman whistled for the foul.
Morton scored 20 points in the fourth quarter yesterday, all on free throws. They've been a bit unconventional offensively this year with the loss of Chandler Ryan, but they found ways to get it done.
Maybe an example of a team that's better than the sum of their parts. Bisping, nice catch inside on a little alley-oop pass from Warham, and she's headed back to the free throw line. She is just relentless.
So tough under the basket. Good pass, but a lot of pressure under the basket too from the defense. Thorne down there, McGee under the basket when she's in the game.
She is the second Bisping to score 1,000 points or more, go along with big sister Brooke. Cassidy Sherman back in for the Potters. Becker, she says she's one of the most tenacious players he's ever coached. 13 in the first half, almost matching her season average.
He also says he's one of the most disliked players in the conference because she's so tough.
Yeah. You sure want her on her team, though. And Bob Becker says, if I got to pick out of all the players in Central Illinois, she's who I pick first.
North Lawndale really not pushing it offensively there to end the quarter. They'll just try to reset at this halftime and find a way to break through that tough Lady Potters defense.
North Lawndale scored a couple of buckets to cut into that Morton 12-point lead, but they get it back to 12 here at the break. Let's go over to Zach Kirker.
Guys, I've got Morton head coach Bob Becker. Coach, is there anything about that first half you're not happy with?
I mean, we're happy where we are, but there's nothing less important than the score half right now. So we've got to continue to execute well and try to pick and choose. You know, I think we're attacking the paint pretty well, getting to the free throw line. Good first half for us so far.
Brandi Bisping flirting with a double-double already, 11-7. You're just used to seeing that from her, I'm assuming, at this point.
Yeah, when she goes beast mode, we've got something good going. So that's what we're hoping for. I thought she floated to the perimeter, you know, really early, but we took her back out, and she went back in there, and then she hits a three, so she's happy again, and then she goes back inside. So she gets beat on a little bit, but we're going to just keep feeding the beast.
Coach, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Bob Becker, head coach of the Morton Potters, who lead 25-13 at the half. Beast mode, he said. We'll be back with the 3A third place trophy ceremony after this. All right, 16 minutes away from crowning a 3A state champion. We got the hardware taken care of for the third place, fourth place. Let's take a look at the highlights from the first half of this 3A title contest between Morton and North Lawndale. And it was the defending state champ Potters who came out strong. Kayla McCormick with a big baseline drive, and then she looks down the ball movement. Kick out to Tinley Dowell. Knocks down the three. A 7-0 run for Morton to start this one. They would run that lead to 12-1. Brandi Bisping with a huge first half. Eventually in the second quarter, North Lawndale gets their first field goal of the game. 5:48 into the left in the second quarter when they knock that down. But answers on answers from Morton. Josie Becker with the three, and then Bisping showing she's got the inside and the outside game. She knocks down a three. North Lawndale would keep it within a dozen. Kia Brooks knocks down the triple to try and stay on the offense, but it was just too much Bisping. 13 points, 7 rebounds, 2 points and 1 rebound coming on that play right there. And she is largely the reason that Morton is up a dozen at the half of this game. North Lawndale just not shooting the ball well in the first half. 26% from the field, 1 of 6 from downtown. They made shots from deep yesterday, have not been able to do that. And you know the one thing that Morton is going to do is hit their free throws. They are 6 of 7 from the charity stripe so far in the first half. That is what they are known for, and they are living up to the billing. They've also got a 5 rebound advantage and second chance points just owned by the Potters. A lot of that, the work of Bisping down low, getting those second chance points. 25-13 is the score at the half. A 12-point advantage for the defending state champ, Morton Potters. We'll be back after this. Third quarter action coming up in just a minute. 25-13, Morton leading North Lawndale in the 3A state championship game. I've got North Lawndale head coach Corey Morgan. Coach, 1 point in the first quarter in the state championship game. Were there nerves from the girls? What did you feel?
I think there were a little bit of nerves. I think we were taking good shots. It was just kind of a lid on a basket. We couldn't finish anything.
I heard you tell them we've been here before. State champion, or the championship game of the State Farm Classic. You guys were trailed Rock Island 16-3. How helpful will it be being in that situation earlier this year?
Extremely helpful. I got a group of fighters. I'm confident they're going to push back little by little. We'll get back in the game.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. We will have highlights of that second half action. In fact, we'll have the call of it when we get back momentarily here on CSN. It is the 3A state championship game, Morton and North Lawndale. We're back after this.
We are back at Redbird Arena, 25-13. Morton with the lead as we go into the third quarter. And interesting to hear Bob Becker going into halftime. Were you satisfied with just about everything? it's hard to find too much fault in that first half.
Well, and I think the most important thing he said at that point was the thing, nothing could matter less than the score at halftime. That's what he said at the end of a terrific half of basketball, but that's done and over. They have to play one more half.
Halfway toward repeating a state championship from a year ago. Quick three by Kia Brooks off the mark. Becker almost walked. Interesting little side story. Leading scorer Chandler Ryan, as Bisping will head back to the line. Took off her sweatsuit. She's got her uniform on. She walked out very emotional during warm-ups and stood under the basket while her teammates warmed up. You get a look at her. Incredible attitude for somebody that lost their senior year. Bisping now with 14 points. Prior to that, she had scored all of her 13 points in that second quarter.
She took over the game in the second quarter.
Potter's up 14. Well, Bob Becker a year ago put his daughter into the ball game when she had a torn ACL. Might we see Chandler Ryan on the floor before the day is over for a cameo appearance? Jada Thorpe.
Not quite the appearance that she imagined after last year's victory here.
Foul on Brandi Bisping, who just set the 3A free throw record with 25 made free throws in the tournament. 19 of them coming yesterday in the win over Morgan Park.
And she beat the record set by Chandler Ryan.
Allman for three. North Lawndale crashing the boards, unable to come up with it. Here come the Potters in transition. McCormick will pull it back out.
Dejanay Bibby is still down on the floor.
Corey Morgan and trainers will come out to take a look at her. Hopefully she'll be okay. Kind of flew after that rebound.
Couple of players went up. She just came down hard. May have tripped over a couple of people on the way down. May have hit her elbow, it looks like.
Like she was reaching for her elbow. And Shanae Bibby gets a nice hand from the crowd as she's able to get up and walk off under her own power. 6:31 to go here in the third. Morton a 14-point lead. Brandi Bisping has scored 9 straight for the Lady Potters. They beat Rochester by 10 in the state championship a year ago. Jada Thorpe whistled for the foul. What they have done to some of the traditional powers. They beat Montini in the semis by 14 a year ago. They beat Morgan Park by 15 yesterday. And now the Lady Phoenix getting aggressive on defense and paying the price for it a little bit with the whistles. Marquita Thorne with the foul.
And that is likely not going to help their case here because, as we've said, Morton at the free throw line is about as dominant as they come.
Jadison Warren follows her own shot. and gets her first points of the afternoon after scoring 15 in the win over Morgan Park.
Such a tough player. She was not going to give up on that second chance attempt.
A 16-point Morton lead as Jada Thorpe puts it on the floor and draws contact. Take another look at the extra effort by the senior, Jadison Warham.
Defensive position under the basket there was actually better on the second attempt. So Warham had a little bit more to go to deal with on that second attempt there.
Deasa Allman.
She's been looking for that shot all afternoon.
And that stops a 9-0 run by the Potters. 5:30 to go in the third. You might wonder where that nickname comes from. There were, back in the day, there were a lot of pottery producers in Morton. And a double foul called inside. Randy Bisping. And it looks like Marquita Thorne got tied up inside.
They've been pretty physical under the basket most of the game. Maybe a little added tension now that we're into the second half.
Now, you talked earlier about Brandy maybe being the most disliked player in the conference. She is nasty on the court. And that's from her head coach, Bob Becker. He talks about her beast mode, and she will sometimes float around the perimeter and not go inside and really mix it up. And that's what he likes to see, is that beast mode when she mixes it up inside. Foul was on Jada Thorpe. And it'll be Morton ball again. We played 3 minutes here in the third. Morton has increased their lead. Warham again inside.
She's heating up.
Did not score in the first half. Kia Brooks takes it all the way.
Warham and Brooks were really the players for these two teams yesterday that set the stage for their success in the semifinal games. They've both been quiet thus far.
Bob Becker went to Jarrett Brown, the boys basketball coach at Morton, and took a little from his playbook. Brown helping out with something they call a triangle. They ran it a lot yesterday. You could look over, see Bob Becker making that triangle sign with his hands. They ran it a lot, got a lot of back cuts against Morgan Park. Warham whistle for the travel that time. A lot of contact, maybe. Kamira McGee bodying up defensively. But Jadison Warham is waking up here in the third quarter, and it's all Morton midway through the third.
Randy Bisping and I go to Morton High School. If I could have any talent, I would be able to tumble, because a lot of my friends can tumble, and I just think it looks really cool. If I could have any superhuman talent, I would be able to fly, because then I wouldn't have to deal with traffic. Some music that people would be surprised that I listen to is country music. If I could play any other sport, I would play soccer, because I used to play it when I was younger, and I always thought it was really fun. If I could speak any language, I would speak Mandarin, because no one else around here can really speak it, and I think it sounds cool. My ideal vacation destination would be to go to Bora Bora or anywhere on the beach, because I like to go swimming. My pregame ritual is before every game, I drink Amino Energy so I can get a little more focused and energized for the game.
Bora Bora, huh? Sounds good about now.
I'd be all right with that vacation.
The Asa Allman three, no good. And McGee, well, she's really good at that. She's done that a couple of times.
She's practiced that move a time or two.
Leaping out of bounds and throwing it off the other player.
And I can tell you, as a defender, that drives you crazy, because there's nothing you can do.
3-point attempt from Bisping, or is no good, rather, and Thorpe on the rebound. Blocked by our own cameraman here. Jada Thorpe will go to the line. Corey Morgan says she's flat out phenomenal. averaging 14 points a game as a freshman, the leading scorer on this team.
As a coach, it's fun to see a freshman with that kind of talent, that kind of leadership ability, to watch them move through a season where you make it all the way to the state championship game and know that you've got three more years of this kid.
Yeah, Lewis has got a front row seat right there behind the North Lawndale bench. He's taken his teams to Peoria in the past. Data hits both free throws, and it's a 12-point game.
There comes that pressure.
And the Lady Phoenix will get it back. Bob Becker wants to talk it over. He doesn't want his team to get complacent here or make any unforced errors, and they had a little trouble there with the pressure. When two African-American teens are recruited from inner city Chicago to play basketball, their dreams of NBA stardom are tested by issues with school, money, and family. It's Hoop Dreams. Catch this extraordinary true story this Sunday, 7 o'clock on CSN Chicago. See a little of America's original March Madness there, too, as Arthur Agee's Marshall team went to state back in 91. You can see Corey Morgan kind of giving him what for over there. He is a third grade teacher. He had Brooks and Esther in his third grade classroom.
And on elementary teams.
Deshaunae Bibby came as a fourth grader.
Brooks well. Kia Brooks was a star for this team yesterday. She's doing everything she can to weld them back into this one. A little inside, a little outside.
She's got 8 points to lead the Phoenix. Talk about bloodlines. Her sister Kiara played at Indiana State, so she played a game a year here at Redbird Arena in the Missouri Valley Conference. Here you get a look at Kia. Her 21 against Highland, leading the team, season best for her. Try to work it inside to Brooks, and the foul will go against the Potters.
They've not been able to make that play work consistently today. But if they can get that going, they can cut into this lead. It looks daunting right now, but they do have time if they can get things rolling.
Let's throw it to Zach Kirker.
Guys, if you think Bob Becker's done coaching this one, think again that last time out that he called, he was adamant about two things. He said there is little to no resistance on these takes from North Lawndale. They're scoring way too quickly, and he said that if you're not in the right spots in this press breaker, you turn the ball over like they did just before he took that timeout. He said that is their only chance. A little resistance on D and turning the ball over. He said otherwise we're fine, but he said that will let them get back into this game. We cannot let that happen.
No, Bob Becker won't quit coaching no matter what the difference. He's not looking at the score.
I think he's going to be much happier with that attempt at breaking the press.
Kaylee Jones, the sophomore, with the nice look to Jadison Warham, who's got all six of her points here in the third quarter. And it's back to a 14-point Morton lead. Deshaunae Bibby to the hoop.
Good to see her back in the game after hitting the floor hard moments ago.
Her first field goal, now the pressure. Jones brings it across. Has it taken away from behind. And now the Lady Phoenix throw it away. Boy, if you get a turnover down 12, you cannot give it right back like that.
They're creating chances for themselves and then giving them up just as easily. And that's leading to a lot of frustration defensively, and then they're making mistakes.
Becker misses on the cut to the hoop. Here's Thorpe missing the layup. Bisping, the rebound. Gets it ahead to Becker. Now it's 4-on-1. And the one is number one in your program and number one in the Phoenix Hearts. Kia Brooks tapped it away. Boy, that's like stopping a breakaway goal in hockey. And there was a great bucket there. Jones to Warham. Lawndale answering at the other end with Deshaunay Bibby.
Well, those quick hands by Brooks gave her defense a chance to get set. They didn't hustle back down the floor, and both Brooks and Coach Morgan were too pleased with that.
4-on-1, and she somehow was able to deny the basket. Strong take by Kaylee Jones, a confident young player, according to Bob Becker. Morton back up 14 after a little run by the Phoenix. Crashing the offensive glass, but nothing to show for it.
Another
here come the Potters
now.
And another hard hit on the floor.
That one looks like maybe an ankle.
Can't see who it is. Kamira McGee.
Really battling under the basket for those rebounds. See if we can tell what happened here.
Looked like her own player landed on her.
Sure did. Boy, she's not putting any pressure on that foot either.
Ariana Williamson landed on her inadvertently. Hate to see that.
Just a lot of toughness, a lot of determination from their post players today, really having to battle against this Morton team to come up with those rebounds. We've seen a couple of players kind of pay the price for that aggressiveness.
Final minute, third quarter, Morton up 14. Bisping pulls it back out. Dow gets around a defender but can't finish. Deasa Allman, tough shot by Deasa Allman at just 5-1.
She can play a little. She's had some tough luck with shots not going down today.
McCormick tied up. Jada Thorpe wanted a jump ball.
Watch this move. Right up and under. Nice touch.
Jada Thorpe whistled for her third foul. Jadison Warham coming back in for Morton. Haley Jones giving the Potters some good minutes as a sophomore. Ariana Williamson back in for North Lawndale. 16.1 left, third quarter. Morton trying to make it back-to-back state championships in Class 3A. Bennett Academy will try to do that same thing tonight in 4A. Bisping on the back cut, the great look from Warham.
Great cut, great pass.
Kia Brooks at the buzzer, no good. And Morton takes its biggest lead of the game on the back cut. The senior Warham to the junior Bisping, and it's a 37-23 Morton lead. There's the Morton roller coaster. Oh, it's a wild ride. They lead it 14. Not much of a roller coaster ride on the floor, thanks to Brandi Bisping. 17 points. She went to the line for three and ones in this game. She's helped her team to a 14-point lead.
Just so tough, so determined under the basket.
She had a season best 29 over Springfield in a win. Morton only lost three games this year. One of them, of course, to North Lawndale in four overtimes. They lost a conference game by two to East Peoria and lost to Quincy Notre Dame by five. Kenley Dow, the freshman, bringing it across with the pressure from Allman, the sophomore. A couple of underclassmen going at it. North Lawndale down 14. Zach Kirker talked about how they came back from double-digit deficit in the championship game of the State Farm Classic. They've got their work cut out for them here against a very disciplined Morton Potters team.
You know, we talked about this being a rematch.
Dow on the drive.
And that North Lawndale was able to beat Morton in that tournament. But that was really just, what, 2 weeks after they lost Chandler Ryan for the season. They've had to learn how to play without her, and they may be a much different team today than they were in that tournament.
We've seen a lot of Tinley Dow. She started her career at Blessed Sacrament School in Morton. She's always played up a grade or two, played with my daughter Chloe. She is just such a young thing out there. Bob Becker said she's a little bit like a baby giraffe. She's got big feet. She's going to grow into that body. He thinks she's going to be a six-footer and a Division I player someday.
Well, not only does she have just some talent that you can see as a freshman, but she's got a good head on her shoulders. She sees the floor pretty well. She knows when to attack, when to pull back. Those are all great things to see out of a freshman.
Cassidy Sherman back into the ball game, takes Dowell's spot. Allman tries another acrobatic shot and hits. Deasa Allman with a couple of wild acrobatic shots. It looks like something you'd see here at the halftime of an Illinois State game off of the trampolines. Look at that.
Just a great touch.
Morton inbounds against the full court pressure, up 14. Josie Becker battles her way across half court and picks up the foul on Kia Brooks.
Morton back at the free throw line.
Josie Becker as a seventh grader. Team won a state title. The junior Potters, 52-1 in junior high in her career. Got a younger sister who very likely play basketball for dad at Morton High School. She's got five. And it's Morton up handily here. 16-point lead now. Biggest of the game. Warren with the steal. And I think if you catch the Morton folks in an unguarded moment as Allman comes up with the steal and the layup, I think there might be the thought in the Morton camp that maybe there was a little bit of not enough respect paid for the defending state champions. I think there was a lot of talk about Morgan Park and North Lawndale getting a rematch and maybe a public league final, and Morton was having no part of that on either day.
Nice to see Allman not giving in too early, though.
Not
big
at all.
Hole to climb out of for North Lawndale, but still playing tough.
She's listed at 5'1". Corey Morgan says she might be 5 feet tall and 6-inch heels.
That looks pretty accurate.
Look at her. She's playing a little defense, though. How you doing, Cassidy Sherman?
A little defense, a little mental game.
Yeah.
Not sure they can intimidate their way out of this
and
one.
The big Morton fan contingent would yell, scoreboard, scoreboard, scoreboard. Great crowd here again for Morton. Again, Morton just about a half hour west on I-74.
Another
just outside
cut.
Peoria as Warham finds Kayla McCormick.
Saw that open baseline and took advantage.
And that's the other thing that happened. Morgan Park yesterday. Jadison Warham, let's give her full credit. She has not scored as much today, but we have seen her make some excellent passes. And at the other end, I thought we saw it from Morgan Park, kind of atypical. So just some wild shots and not very good shot selection. And that's what kind of the way Morton plays kind of lulls you into that, where nothing's working. We got to just jack up a shot as quick as we can.
Well, that's by design, too, as there's another shot for Allman.
Well, that was not anything that she was hurrying. I mean, that was when she knew she was going to shoot that before she got it. That was not rushed. 2-on-1, Sherman to Warham. Can't get it to fall, and she fouls on the rebound. No, that was... That time was not an example of kind of being hurried and taking a poor shot. That was something IHSA Allman has been waiting to get that open shot all afternoon.
Coach Becker says that their defensive philosophy is no bad one. They want to keep them to no shot, a bad shot, or one shot. And today and yesterday against Morgan Park, that's pretty much what we saw.
Allman scored 9 straight points for North Lawndale. And a foul before the shot will go against Brandi Bispin. Tried to take a charge. Or no?
Now they're saying it's against Brooks.
And now they're going to talk about it. I don't feel bad now. When the referees have to talk about it, I don't feel bad for being confused. Because the initial indication was a push, and Brandi Bispin thought it was against her because she was kind of making a face.
She kind of couldn't believe that it was against her. And then all of a sudden it wasn't.
And it was against North Lawndale. Well, the folks on that side of the arena are a little confused. Foul was on Brooks. A little confusing on the mechanics there as Corey Morgan gets a explanation on the other side. And look where Brandi Bisping is again.
Meanwhile,
Brandi Bisping is shooting more free throws. She's Story already the set
tournament.
The record. Yeah, she set the record for made free throws in this tournament this weekend.
Why not add 2 more?
19 points for her after scoring 21 against Morgan Park. 19 of those coming at the free throw line. Only 8 at the free throw line today. She's
slacking.
Slack.
But she's making up for it with some defensive plays like that. Although this time,
Markina
she's the one.
Thorne the takeaway. And she almost had a shot at the 3-point play. Instead, she'll shoot free throws. And that'll be the 4th personal foul on Brandi Bisping. She's in foul trouble, but her team is comfortably ahead by 15. Lincoln Way East providing the entertainment, and you're not getting the best of the cowbell player. He really kind of calms down once we come back from break.
Well, he had a tambourine just before we came back from break, too.
Multi-talented.
He's changing it up.
Yeah. Seen some posts on Facebook from some of my Morton friends, and they are all about the cowbell guy.
He's going to have quite the following after a weekend at the state tournament.
You bet he will. I need more cowbell.
He's got it for you. So he's got you covered.
And correction, Brandi Bisping with three personal fouls. And it's Marquita Thorne at the line. Just a 54% free throw shooter. 5'7" junior. Rolls in the second one, and it's still a 14-point lead for the defending state champs from Morton. Dow to the hoop again. She's been able to get to the hoop, hasn't gotten the shots to fall, but she's gone to the free throw line. She got the shots to fall very early. Made a couple of buckets, actually scored 7 points in that first half for Bob Becker. Bob Becker, a Sycamore native. His claim to fame before winning the state championship was playing for the intramural championship at the University of Illinois in the building formerly known as the Assembly Hall in front of 50 folks, including his now wife. Well, she was impressed.
That's all that matters, right? And that they won.
Bill Davis, his longtime assistant next to him. He was a heck of a player for Morton back in the 70s. So dedicated to his school, he has the mascot logo tattooed on his leg.
That's commitment.
Kia Brooks with a fancy move. And now here's Sherman with the rebound. Bringing it up against the withering North Lawndale pressure, but Morton has withstood that most of this game. Just 9 turnovers for Morton. They only turned it over 7 times yesterday against Morgan Park. The fundamentals, you know, it's not always flashy or fancy, but look at what it's done for Morton this weekend.
Sometimes that style of play is what leads to maybe not having the attention coming in.
And that whistle goes against Bisping, and that will be her 4th foul.
That said, you don't win championships because of the attention you have coming in. You win championships because you're disciplined enough to play in the toughest of games, and we've seen in the last 2 days that that's what Morton does perhaps better than anyone else in the state.
Well, and you hear teams talk about it all the time when injuries happen, next man up, next man up, and this team has epitomized that, losing their leading scorer Chandler Ryan, who is averaging 19 points a game. Now the silver lining, Bob Becker says, to the whole thing was it did happen early in the season, and his girls learned how to play together and step up in the absence of their leading scorer.
And having the experience of being state champions last year, they kind of know what they're up against, what it takes to win, but they had to find new ways to do that because they couldn't count on that offensive boost from Chandler Ryan.
Well, and they've known how to win all along. We mentioned Josie Becker and the girls in junior high going 52-1. Tinley Dow, when she was at Blessed Sacrament, when she was, I can't remember if she was a 6th grader, she might have even been a 5th grader, helped lead 7th grade team to the IHSA 3rd place finish. So they've won at every level. And that, I think that, maybe because I live there, my daughters have been through it, but when they win at every level and you see the girls come up like Tinley Dow and Kaylee Jones, freshmen and sophomores like Cassidy Sherman coming in and filling those spots and carrying on that tradition that Bob Becker's built there since 2007, getting back to state again and again and again.
Well, there's something about when you see a team with successful freshmen at the varsity level, they know the system, they know the expectations, they know the people that they're playing with. All of those things add to a comfort level within that team chemistry. But there's also something about learning how to win and getting down to the last 4 possessions of a game in a close game and knowing how to make it turn out in your favor. And they've certainly been able to do that by taking advantage of having so much success at the younger levels all the way through to this varsity team.
Fouls on Brandi Bisping. That'll be her fifth. Bob Becker had gone to his bench. Jenna Little, number 11, checking in for the Lady Potters. She fouls out. She's what a competitor. What a competitor. Up 17 points. She scores 19, and she is very upset since she fouled out of this game.
But she has nothing to be upset about. She was the defining force for this team in the first half, really took over the game in the second quarter, and never looked back.
Crystal Cobbler now into the ball game for Morton, number 24. And a 30-second timeout for Bob Becker. Still working it, still coaching. Up 48-31, 2:54 away from a back-to-back state championship. Our Country Financial Player of the Game. Who else? Brandi Bisping. 19 points for the junior guard. An incredible performance this weekend. She had a great day at the line yesterday, forcing Morgan Park to foul her and getting to the line. And she's able to score from the field as well today. 19 points to lead the Potters as they are just moments away from a back-to-back state title.
And despite losing Chandler Ryan early this season, Coach Becker said the expectations didn't change. They knew what they had in the team chemistry, in the talent, and Brandi Bisping is a big part of the reason that they didn't have to change their expectations with or without Chandler Ryan.
Montini, the last team to win back-to-back state championships in 3A in 2011-2000 for Jason Nichols. Bob Becker's program just a couple of minutes away from doing that here. And you look at the run that the Potters have made. They were fourth and 13 state champs a year ago. And just moments away from it again here. Fourth trophy since 2007 for Bob Becker's program. That is J.C. Warham, the junior sister of senior Jadison Warham.
And they talked this week about how special it was that they would have the opportunity to play at state together, that this was a story they'd be able to tell years from now about remembering that time they played at state together. Not only are they playing at state together, but they're moments away from winning a state title together.
Foul whistled on Kayla McCormick. Here's the last five 3A state champions. You see Montini winning three of the last five, including those two in a row that we just mentioned. Quincy Notre Dame with a championship in there back in 2013. And Morton about to go back to back here. Bennett Academy will try to go back to back tonight in 4A, a rematch of the 4A state championship game coming up here on Comcast Sportsnet between Bennett Academy and Friend High School. North Lawndale not ready to quit yet. McCormick comes out of there with it. And this is Little, Jenna Little in the ball game now. And Warham has it taken away. Jada Thorpe taking it all the way to the hoop. And a foul will go against North Lawndale's Deshaunay Bibby. Bob Becker's gone to his bench a little bit. North Lawndale didn't get the memo. They are not ready to quit playing with 2:10 to play. And Josie Becker will return for the Lady Potters.
Still just as aggressive. defensively and still fighting to put points on the board. You heard Coach Morgan at halftime say that there seemed to be a bit of a lid on the basket. Unfortunately for his team, that hasn't gone away for them in the second half.
My old buddy Kayla McCormick at the free throw line, good soccer player. She and my daughter Samantha played on the boys teams until they told them they couldn't play with the boys teams anymore. Jadison Worm getting a nice hand. Soccer season will start Monday for Kayla McCormick and the Lady Potters. Still 2 minutes plus left in the state championship game in the basketball season for the Lady Potters as Kia Brooks knocks down the three. She's now in double figures with 11. Kia Brooks, the sharp shooter, slasher. She can knock down the threes too. That's number 41 on the season for the junior Kia Brooks. Catch the IHSA boys basketball 1A and 2A semifinals and championship games right here only on CSN Chicago. Games start Friday at noon. The game's also streaming live on csnchicago.com/Illinois High School. CSN Chicago, your home for IHSA championships. And this evening will mark the halfway point for America's original March Madness. The girls will finish up, and the boys will take over next week at Carver Arena in Peoria.
Plenty of exciting basketball to watch if you're an Illinois basketball fan. Some hardware to hand out.
It'll be the 21st season in Peoria. If my math is correct, this is the 25th year here at Redbird Arena. .201 left in this state championship finale. Becker picked it up, lost it, tried to get it back, but couldn't. Deasa Allman, another little floater, but Deshaun A. Bibby is there for the follow. Potters beat the pressure this time. Trying to run out the clock here. Be another fire engine ride in their futures as Kayla McCormick is fouled.
Unfortunately for the Phoenix, you see the frustration on those fouls. They've been in a position where they've had to be aggressive on defense the entire game, which is now putting the Potters at the free throw line. Where they excel.
Makes the first, yeah. Bridget Wood, a 5'6 freshman into the ball game now for Morton. Another Blessed Sacrament Tar, the parochial Catholic school there in Morton. McCormick makes them both. And we saw this from Morton yesterday. I thought it epitomized their run here back to the state championship game. And they just have this refuse to lose attitude. I mean, unbelievable postseason run. And Bob Becker says, our kids have just found a way to get it done. Holding people down, it wasn't always pretty. Defensively holding the first five opponents in the postseason to an average of 30 a game.
You can hear the chants beginning from the student section, back to back.
Yeah. Another pretty good contingent. You always expect a good fan base here on Friday when everybody gets out of school early. At least during the afternoon games, but they have returned in force from Morton. Crystal Cobbler misses the free throw. She's a 5'4 sophomore. And a big hand for senior Kayla McCormick as she comes off. Big smile on her face. Cobbler makes the second. The Morton Heat program has been a youth travel team that has really helped educate the young Morton girls in game of basketball. Bob Becker himself has coached some of those teams. Oh, and a two-hand push in the back there, and just you hate to see that. I know it's a frustrating game, but you can't let those kind of, you just can't do those kind of things. Deshaunae Bibby whistled for the intentional foul.
Coach Morgan telling her the same thing. It's just the frustration that's built up over the course of this game, but not how he wants to see them finishing this one.
Well, anybody that's been a parent of a teenager knows they make bad decisions a lot. And here's little Bridgie Wood. I've known her since she was about 3 years old. And now we're doing a game with her in it. Somebody's getting old. I think it's her.
Probably. But she is continuing the trend at the free throw line.
And look at the young Potter players at standing at half court. That's the future of the Morton program right there. Tinley Dowell, J.C. Warham.
And what an
Kaylee
experience.
Jones, Crystal Cobbler. A little bit tougher at the other end of the floor.
A remarkable season.
An incredible run.
Right.
I mean, 11 losses and you still get yourself and your game together to make it to the state championship game. I mean, you can't say enough about what North Lawndale's done to get here. Avenged an early season loss to Marshall. Perennial Chicago Power.
Some strong young talent on that side of the floor as well. Certainly going to take this experience and build on it, use this as motivation to try to get back to the same spot next year.
You can hear the Morton crowd chanting, "We want Chandler." And Bob Becker's talking to her.
There
here she comes. Oh my.
What a moment. And what a roar from this crowd.
The official says we still have to go by the book here. Now she comes in. And a big hug from the freshman. And what a mentor she has been to Tinley Dowell. And we talked to Chandler Ryan just a few days after her injury, and just such a positive attitude. I mean, she mourned the loss of this season for a day or so, as you would imagine. But she has been such a great role model, always the first off the bench. Just such great mentoring, as we mentioned, such emotional support for this young team. And I think any of those players, and Bob Becker will tell you that she's a huge part of how, why this team got back here, even though she wasn't on the floor.
Well, it takes a lot for a team to be able to figure out what to do next when you lose that player. But they've rallied around her and used her experience, used her basketball IQ, used just that motivation of wanting to get her this moment. And they've created a remarkable ride and a remarkable story for all of the Morton fans and, of course, for Chandler Ryan, despite not playing in this tournament.
And those are tears of joy. Those are absolute tears of joy that she was just able to step out on that floor one last time.
I imagine when Coach Becker gave his daughter that moment last year, he didn't anticipate having to do it again the second season. But what a moment that was.
And I can tell you that she is a battler, a fighter on the floor, but she is one sweet young lady. Just couldn't be more proud of her if she was my own for what she's done this season and how she's handled. I mean, what is a heartbreaking injury. Bailey Fogle also out on the floor now for Morton.
Brianna Dueling, just a freshman for the Phoenix.
Crystal Cobbler back to the line. This is a young lady that really grew into her role as a point guard, as a grade school player, really struggled at times, and boy, to see the improvement she made over the years has been great to see. Bailey Fogle got a little bit of a cameo appearance out there, a senior transfer. Somebody came back in for her. It was Bridget Wood back in now for Morton. Final seconds. As North Lawndale continues to battle, but it's Morton with back-to-back state championships in Class 3A. The Lady Potters, led by Chandler Ryan a year ago on the floor. Her emotional support helping get them back here. Bob Becker with a nod to the very vocal fans from Morton that have turned out all year for his Lady Potters. Great support for that program. They win back-to-back state champions and say, hey, we play basketball south of I-82, you know.
They're one of their team mottos this year. There's a sign in the stand that says, strong alone, champions together. And if anything defines this Morton team this season, that must be it.
Well, and Bob will say, you know, you look at us, we're not too imposing. You can't measure our heart, though, and the grit and the guts that our team plays with game in, game out. And maybe the gutsiest player is with Zach right now.
That's right, guys. I've got Brandy Bisping, the country financial player of the game. How does back-to-back sound, Brandy?
Oh my gosh, it's amazing. I'm so proud of my team and everything that we've worked for. And it's just so amazing to be able to share this and do this for our seniors and be here today.
Did you feel like maybe there were some teams and some people underestimating what the defending state champ was capable of coming back into the state tournament?
Yeah, I definitely did. A lot of my friends were saying, oh, Morgan Park's really good. And I'm like, I agree with you, but I think we can do it. And I mean, there's always gonna be people who doubt you, but it doesn't matter what they think, it matters what you think.
You are one of a number of players who will return on this team. It's back to back now. Have you thought about what this team's capable of beyond this?
We actually have. We want to go three. We want to go three. We always say we love threes. We go 33-3 2 years in a row, and we're trying to get three state championships in a row.
There you go. She says they're coming back for another one. Brandy Bisping, appreciate it. Congratulations. Let's bring in their head coach, Bob Becker. Coach, Brandy says that they're already talking about three. I'm sure that you probably just want to take a break and relax and appreciate what number two is. What's the feeling?
Oh, my goodness. I'm just incredibly blessed to have kids like these guys to work with. Great coaching staff. I love working in Morton School District. We got a lot of great things going, and I'm just really, really fortunate. I'm really proud of them. I want them to stop and enjoy this moment again. They worked so hard to get here. And then we'll talk about next, you know, goals in the future. But right now, I mean, they've executed at the state tournament. We played our best basketball right here against two really good teams. And I don't know, it'll sink in, I'm sure.
That moment with Chandler Ryan was pretty special, certainly something that she's earned.
Oh, that's a super kid. I've loved coaching that kid from day one. Special, special kid, a leader, special talent. I'm glad she got a future, you know, at Florida Gulf Coast next year. But we felt like, yeah, we got to get you there. And she had a nice hand from our crowd. Our community supports our team and Chandler. That was a special moment.
Did you guys feel like people maybe weren't paying enough attention to the defending state champs coming in?
You know what? We control what we can control. If people don't want to pay attention to us, it is what it is. I mean, I feel like we've got a great program, great kids, great team, and we're going to battle no matter who's on the floor against us. And that's all we can do.
Coach, congratulations on a second state championship.
Wow, back-to-back. Thank you very much.
There he is, Bob Becker, the head coach of your back-to-back state champion, Morton Potters. They've done it twice, guys.
Jeff Fritzen for the awards.
head coach Corey Morgan. Assistant coach DeJuan White. Assistant coach Shimona McDaniel. Assistant coach Layman Phillips. Manager Keija Hatchett. Manager Tamara Rimmer. Manager Amari McNeil. Manager Lewis Thorpe. And the Lady Phoenix number 0, Deasa Allman. Number 1, Kia Brooks. Number 2, Ikayate Esther. Number 3, Marquita Thorne. Number 4, Shinaria Smith. Number 5, Deshane Bibby. Number 11, Jada Thorpe. Number 12, Jamia Lockhart. Number 14, Armani Allen. Number 15, Brianna Dooling. Number 22, Shatavia Wellborn. Number 23, Ariana Williamson. And number 32, Kimaira McGee. At this time, please meet the Potters of Morton High School, who finished the 2016 season in first place with a final record of 33 wins and 3 losses. First meet the superintendent, Lindsay Hall. Principal Marjorie Johnson. Athletic Director Scott Jones. Trainer Katie Gavin. Head coach Bob Becker. Assistant coach William Davis. Assistant coach Megan Hassler. Assistant coach Brooke Bisping.
Thank you.
Scorekeeper Todd Bisping.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. You're welcome.
Scorekeeper Jed Warham. Videographer Matt Jones. Blogger Dave Kindred.
Thank you.
And the Potter squad members, number 1, Tinley Dowell. Number three, Josie Becker. Number four, Chandler Ryan. Number 10, Cassidy Sherman. Number 11, Jenna Little. Number 13, Brandy Bisping. Number 15, Kayla McCormick. Number 20, Bridget Wood. Number 24, Crystal Cobbler. Number 25, Bailey Fogle. Number 30, Jadison Warham. 33, Kaylee Jones. And number 40, J.C. Warham. Now will Coach Morgan and the captains from North Lawndale College Prep please step forward to receive the second place trophy. And now will Coach Becker and the captains from Morton High School please step forward to receive the first place trophy.
So it's back-to-back state championships for the top-ranked Morton Potters. Without their leading scorer, they crafted together back-to-back state championships, back-to-back 33-win seasons.
A remarkable run for this team, and this year having overcome so much adversity, dealing with losing Chandler Ryan, being able to come back and make the changes that they needed to make to get to this point. Such an exciting run for them, and congratulations to the Potters program.
I love how we media people treat people. Two questions in, what about next year? And Brandy Bisping didn't miss a beat. She's talking about three in a row, and they got a lot of youth. I mean, they did it without their senior star this year, and they're talking three in a row in Morton.
She has every reason to believe that they can be right back here next year. So much talent, so much youth. Just a wonderful program and a lot of promising future for them.
Congratulations to North Lawndale for getting to the state championship game. The Phoenix in their first ever trip to state, finishing second. The Morton Lady Potters go back to back. Their fourth trophy at state since 2007. They are back to back state champions under Bob Becker. And a big party tonight in the pumpkin capital of the world. The Morton Lady Potters are your back-to-back 3A state champions. For Zach Kirker, for Tara Wellman, for our entire crew here at Redbird Arena, I'm Lee Hall. So long from Redbird Arena.